Every year, thousands of children are born with fatal heart defects. Many live in countries where the life-saving medical care they need simply doesn't exist. Like this 2-year-old girl from Syria. Niaz was born with a hole between the 2 major arteries in her heart. And without surgery, she will die.
She has a very rare defect. It's very difficult to diagnose, actually. And I think this is why the diagnosis was made so late in life. This is a diagnosis usually made just after birth and should be treated within the first few weeks or few months of life.
Niaz's condition went undiagnosed because she and her family live in a Syrian refugee camp. Her mother has risked everything to find people who can save her daughter's life. She made the difficult journey through Syria, Iraq, and Jordan, then handed her daughter to the only people who were willing to help her. People she had been told are her enemies.
I was afraid to come to Israel at first, but the most important issue was my daughter's health. It was more important for her to receive the care she needs.
The doctors and nurses who are caring for Niaz are all Israelis. They work for an organization called Save a Child's Heart. And their mission is to provide free surgery for children with fatal heart conditions. Since 1995, doctors from Save a Child's Heart have operated on more than 4,000 children from 48 developing countries. Children who would otherwise have died.
Well, Save a Child's Heart, the belief is that every child deserves the best medical treatment that we can afford to give. Today, Israel's in a situation that Israeli children get all the medical care that they need in the field of heart problems. And therefore, we consider it our duty to reach out and help others around the world. And we talk about reaching out and helping others around the world, then we first of all always look to our neighbors. And when we look around ourselves, we see a Middle East which is troubled, which is in need. And when we look to the south, we see a tremendous need in Africa. Every child deserves the best medical treatment that Save a Child's Heart can give, and it really doesn't matter what religious background the child comes from. That is the motto of Save a Child's Heart: a child is a child.
These surgeons have seen the world's toughest cases, but Niaz was especially challenging.
When she arrived to us at the age of 1 year and 10 months, she already had damage to the lungs. This makes the surgery even more difficult.
The surgery took several hours, and afterwards, Niaz needed several days of follow-up care.
What we saw in the echo following surgery is, although she came late, the results were amazing. And she will have a normal life. She can do sports, she can get married and have children, she can go to university first, she can become a doctor, whatever. Her prognosis right now is that of a normal child. She would have died in infancy. Not in adolescence or an adult, she would have died in infancy. We took a child with no prognosis and we turned her into a healthy child. This is what medicine is all about.
Knowing that nobody else would do it, and the patient will die if we will not be doing the surgeries. And to see the patients recovering, it's beyond any description.
Niaz and her mother returned to Syria with a new view of their neighbors to the south.
Now that my daughter has had her surgery, I feel very blessed and at peace. The people here in the hospital and in Israel have been so good to me. When I get home, I will tell everyone how much the Israelis helped us and took care of my daughter.
Over the past few years, I would say that one of the very few positive things which have come out of the wars, I would say Iraq and Syria, is the ability of building bridges between nations, of bringing people together, Israelis together with Syrians, with Iraqis, Jordanians, and Palestinians, all under the same roof here at Wolfson Medical Center, getting to know each other.
Right atrium, right ventricle, left atrium, left ventricle.
Doctors from Save a Child's Heart analyze cases from all over the world to determine the best candidates for surgery. The children then travel to Israel, some with a parent, and others with a volunteer guardian. Their surgeries are performed here at the Wolfson Medical Center in the city of Holon, just outside Tel Aviv. Today, children and parents live in this house near the hospital while they're recovering from surgery. But when Save a Child's Heart began in 1995, there was no children's home. So the patients recovered in the home of the program's founder, Dr. Ami Cohen.
The first children who arrived here from Ethiopia had no home to go to. As the program started to evolve and more children started to come to Israel, it became apparent that there was a need to take care of the children. It was not only about the medical care. It was the pre-care and it was the post-care after the discharge from the hospital. And that was where the notion of Save a Child's Heart was sort of to take things one step further and to try and create a home away from home for the children here in Israel. And this is where they spend at least a month after surgery.
The kids are used to food from their country, so the moms cook food that they're used to and they can have that piece of home with them. And then they all sit by their country, so they're all eating what they've grown up with.
We have phenomenal support from young people all around the world who are coming to volunteer and spend time with their children here in Israel. Many of these children are here without their parents, and young volunteers who come from overseas to volunteer, they actually serve as surrogates for these children.
As a volunteer at Save a Child's Heart, I see my role really as making the children happy, making them smile, making this experience better than it would be. I love to play with them and sit and just have fun.
It's a really hard thing. They're coming to a different country to get open heart surgery. And we try to plan activities and say, okay, time for arts and crafts, let's go. But if they're not in the mood, they're not gonna be happy. That's not us doing our job. So you have to see what they wanna do, what's gonna make them most happy and do that.
More than 50% of the children treated are Palestinians from the West Bank and Gaza. These families not only receive surgery, they also attend free weekly clinics and support groups.
I started to work with them because they needed someone to translate, basically. But I'm not only translating, I'm translating feelings and emotions. Every Tuesday we have a Palestinian clinic in which Palestinians from the West Bank and Gaza are coming to the clinic. So I'm there to help them, to be like the contact person between the families and the doctors. I'm the only person in the organization who can speak with them in their language and their culture also. So we talk. We share experiences, stories, and feelings. And to know each other, I think it's a good opportunity. Because at the end of the day, they all are the same. They all have children with health problems.
Diana is a four-month-old baby from Ramallah. Like Niaz, she was also born with a hole in her heart.
It affects her growth. She's not growing properly because her heart is working too hard. So it's like it's burning energy. She has difficulty feeding all her milk. She drinks little at a time because she gets tired very easily. Sometimes she sweats for no reason, even if she's not moving, because her heart is working more than it should be working. She's almost always tired. She wakes up very frequently to feed because she's not feeding enough every time. So I'm tired and she's tired with this condition. And they told me hopefully with surgery it will fix this problem and everything will be good. That's what I'm hoping. I'm hoping. We're due for surgery in a couple of hours, so I'm very nervous.
Finally, it was time for Diana to go to the operating room. On her surgical team is a Palestinian doctor from the West Bank city of Nablus. Dr. Ahmed Zarour is part of the residency program here at Wolfson Hospital, where he'll be trained by Israeli surgeons for the next 6 years.
Really, I'm feeling good with all my colleagues. We are working together as a team, and I feel happy here, and I hope to continue.
The surgery was life-changing for both Diana and her mother.
I met some very nice people, and everybody is helpful over here. The main focus is helping the child, you know? It changed my experience because I never interacted with people from the other side, the Jewish people, with just us. But now we interact with a lot of people, Jewish people, African people, Iraqi people. It's good experience. You get to know people as individuals. It's a very good experience.
Maybe people will call me naive, but dealing with the Palestinians and people and patients coming from enemies' countries, they know what we did for their child. And it put everything in new perspective. It seems that we are not the monster that everybody wants to draw us. I think it's like trust-building steps.
Many of the cardiac patients here come from Africa, like 9-year-old Desiree from Uganda. She spent most of her life in hospitals, but none of the doctors in her country could help. So her mother brought her to Israel.
Me, I'm a Bible reader. So whatever, most of the things that I've read about the Israelites, I've found them happening here. Even the name of their money, I knew it from the Bible. So when I came here, I saw it with my eyes, the name Shekels. Yeah, and when I heard that I'm coming to Israel, I said, I'm the luckiest lady. Here we were welcomed very well. We are really happy. Even when we went to the hospital, it was so, so good that even a doctor pinching you with a needle, she says sorry, which is really very good to us. We are feeling at home so much.
A month after Desiree's surgery, doctors gave her a clean bill of health.
You're ready to go home?
Yes.
Yeah. You don't sound excited enough to go home.
Yeah, exactly. Otherwise, I'm not sending you if you're not very excited.
This is her last echo. She looks wonderful.
After 6 months, she can do sports. She can go to the Olympics. Wow.
As a Christian, Violet has prayed for Israel every day for years. And now, she says Israel was the answer to her prayers for Desiree.
She was very happy. No longer sick, no longer weak. I'm going to play like other children. I'm going to do everything like I couldn't do. She's putting on weight. She's so excited. I said, God, I thank you because you have brought a new heart to my girl. You have given her a new heart.
Desiree is one of thousands of children in Africa who don't have access to pediatric heart surgeons. And when it's impossible for these young patients to travel to Israel, surgeons from Save a Child's Heart travel to them. Around the world, they hold clinics like this one in Tanzania, where they screen sick children, perform surgeries, and train local doctors and nurses.
We focus a lot on training. We want them to be trained as we were trained. We need to give them the right tools to come back and take over and treat the patients by themselves.
With a new generation of doctors being trained around the world and thousands of success stories from 48 countries, Save a Child's Heart is fulfilling the dream of Israel's founders, who envisioned their country as the light to the nations described by the prophet Isaiah.
Years ago, our ancestors came to Israel as pioneers to settle a land. That was their view and vision of Zionism. Israel of the 21st century is in a completely different position than it was 60 years ago. Today, Israel can actually share its knowledge and expertise with others. When you look at the Ethiopian children talking, playing with the Romanian children, playing with a Tanzanian boy and with a Chinese boy, and you see how nicely these children interact one with another without actually having a common language. But I think the common language that all these children have is that they're human beings.
We need more of these kinds of people in this world.
I'm going to tell people, Israel, rescue my son. I can't forget Israel. I'm waiting for it to see my son going to school. I'm so glad. I'm very, very, very glad to see my son good like this. Give me a five. Yes, he's so good.
There's something very, very special about this place, which is pure goodness and man helping man. And I wish that other people throughout the world could see this side of Israel.